get his hand out.
He have, you told him to get his ID, sir, and his driver's license. Oh my God, please don't tell me he's dead.
Don't touch me.
Get out of the car.
Don't touch me. I'm not under arrest. You don't have the right to take
you me. You are under arrest.
Hey, Bob.
Did you see what he was wearing?
Yeah, a dark hoodie, like a gray hoodie. And
we want justice by any means necessary. We want equality by any means necessary. We don't think that we should have to sit around and wait for some segregationist congressmen and senators and a president from Texas in Washington, D.C. to make up their mind. That our people are due now some degree of civil rights. No, we want it now.
I have a dream today.
I must confess that that dream that I had that day has at many points turned into a nightmare. Now, I'm not one to lose hope. I keep on hoping. I still have faith in the future. But I've had to analyze many things over the last few years, and I would say over the last few months. I've gone through a lot of soul-searching and agonizing moments. And I've come to see that we have many more difficult days ahead, and some of the old optimism was a little superficial, and now it must be tempered with a solid realism. And I think the realistic fact is that we still have a long, long way to go, and that we are involved in a war on Asian soil, which, if not checked and stopped, can poison the very soul of our nation.
One thing his presence in the White House will do, it will make black people in America have to face up to facts, probably for the first time in many, many years. And this in itself is good.
The United States of America government, when it came to treating her citizens of Indian descent fairly, she failed. She put them on reservations. When it came to treating her citizens of Japanese descent fairly, she failed. She put them in internment prison camps. When it came to treating the citizens of African descent fairly, America failed. She put them in chains. The government put them on slave quarters, put them on auction blocks, put them in cotton fields, put them in inferior schools, put them in substandard housing, put them in scientific experiments, put them in the lowest paying jobs, put them outside the equal protection of the law, kept them out of their racist bastions of higher education, and locked them into positions of hopelessness and helplessness. The government gives them the drugs, builds bigger prisons, passes a three-strike law, and then wants us to sing God Bless America? No, no, no. Not God Bless America. God damn America. That's in the Bible for killing innocent people. God damn America for treating her citizens as less than human. God damn America, as long as she tries to act like she is God and she is supreme. The United States government has failed the vast majority of her citizens of African descent.